you know, at a time in human history where we seem extremely divided, you know, what we can take away from the lessons in the ocean is that cultural diversity is extremely important to our survival, whether that's above or below the surface. One big thing I've learned by spending thousands of hours in the company of sperm whales is the power of a community and the strength of a family. And you know, really familiar values like love your grandmother, learn from her lessons because she's probably done it before you, spend time with your siblings because eventually they move away. But importantly also, you know, respect different solutions to everyday problems. You know, your neighbors might have a different way of living, a different set of solutions of how to survive in the world that we live in. But maybe some of those secrets are actually really valuable to you. And that diversity, that cultural diversity, you know, how we learn from each other is critically important to these sperm whales. You know, I think a lot of people in the world recognize how important the vast forests are for us, you know, spread all over the planet. They help us breathe and recycle the carbon dioxide that we breathe out or produce through our industry. But the ocean is actually a really key part of that too. You know, they say every other breath you take comes from the ocean. And the sperm whales are a key part of this whale pump that moves nutrients up and down from the deep to the shallows and allows these, you know, phytoplankton blooms to really lock up carbon in the surface waters. So, you know, when we think about the fact that, you know, human whaling reduced just the sperm whales down to, you know, maybe a quarter of what they were before whaling, we've lost three quarters of our carbon pump in that one species. One of the main threats facing sperm whales right now is marine debris. So whether that's leftover nets from our fishing or plastic pollution in general, virtually no sperm whale that's washed ashore in the last number of years hasn't been full of plastics. Create sort of bigger views and bigger definitions of us. We collectively can make big changes, but it starts with believing in and trusting in the people that live next to us, whether they're humans or whales.